In this video on how to use Zoom on Windows, I will show you 5 essential actions that you can do on Zoom. How to install Zoom, how to join a meeting, how to create an account, how to create a meeting, and how to create a scheduled meeting. So first, let's see how to install Zoom on Windows. For you to install Zoom on Windows, on laptop or PC, you will need to open your preferred browser. Open the browser by double-clicking the icon. Now, on the search bar, write zoom.us. If you are the first time on Zoom site, it might ask you to tap Agree and Proceed. Now, tap Close. Here, on the Zoom site, go to the bottom of the page. On this part of the page, you will see a link called Download. Click on it. Here, click on Download from section Zoom Client for Meetings. Now, the installer will be downloaded on your PC. After the download is complete, click on the file you just saved. Here, click on Yes. You allow this app to make changes to add files to your PC. Now Zoom is installing. After Zoom will install, it will open. If this doesn't happen to you, find the icon on the desktop and double-click it. You have installed Zoom on the PC. The next step is to join a meeting or just sign up for a new account or sign in into your old account. Now, let's see how to join a meeting. If you wish to enter into a meeting, you will need to have the ID of the meeting and also, if needed, a password. Find this info from the host. For you to join a meeting, you need to click the big blue button, Join a meeting. Write the ID of the meeting. You can also select what join option you wish from this list. Zoom can remember your name and also not connect audio and video on entry. Now click on Join. If the meeting has a password, it will appear this pop-up. Write the password and tap OK. If the meeting has not started yet, you will get a screen with a message saying "Waiting for host." Please wait until the host starts the meeting. You cannot do anything. If the meeting is starting and you are the first time on Zoom, it will ask you to agree to the terms of service. Click I agree. You can join a meeting with audio or without. Click Join with computer audio to be able to talk in the meeting. Also note that if this is the first time on Zoom, you might want to click Test speakers and microphone. Just to be safe, it is working. Click Join with computer audio to be able to talk in the meeting. On the bottom right, you have the option to join with audio and video on the meeting. In the center, you have the option to invite persons, see participants, and also share screen if this is allowed by host. Also, in the right part, you have the button to leave the meeting. Now, you have joined a meeting. Now, let's see how to create an account on Windows. Click on Sign In link from the bottom. Here you will be able to sign in with Google and Facebook. But for this test we will use Sign Up Free link. Click it. The software will open your browser with the sign up page from Zoom. If you are the first time on Zoom, it will ask you to click on Agree and Proceed. Then click on Close. Now, write your work email address and then click Sign Up. Now click on Confirm. Now check your email to confirm the account. Let's check the Gmail account. Here is the email we received from Zoom. Click it. Now click Activate Account. Write on this new page the first name and the last name. Also, write the password and confirm password. Click on Continue. Let's skip this step. I do not wish to invite anybody. Now let's log in with our new account. Let's go to Zoom software. Here, write the email and the password you just set up. Click on Sign In. You are now signed in into your account. Now you have created an account and connected it with Zoom app. You can easily now join a meeting, create a new meeting, or schedule a meeting. Now let's see how to create a meeting on Windows. Just follow these steps to create a new meeting on Zoom. On this window, we have the button New Meeting. Below this button, there is an arrow. Click on it. Here, you have the option to start the meeting with video and also the option to use your personal ID. If the option Use My Personal Meeting ID is unchecked, then you will generate a random meeting ID. Tap on the New Meeting button now. If you are for the first time on Zoom, maybe it's better first to test speakers and microphone. So, click on this option. Now, test your speakers. Now, test your microphone. If this works, then it is okay. If not, Zoom will give you some advice. Now, tap on Join with Computer Audio to get the audio on. Let's start the presentation of the option we have on Zoom. Please keep in mind you are the host of the meeting, the person who created the meeting, so you have administrative permissions. At this new meeting, you can tap on the button from the top left to see the ID of the meeting and the password. You can also copy the link and send it to somebody directly. On the bottom part of the Zoom meeting window, we have the audio and video settings. You can click on the button to mute yourself or to speak at the meeting. Near this icon, we have an arrow. Click it. This new menu will have an option to select a microphone or speakers of the computer. You will have the possibility here to test the speakers and microphone as we did on the entry. Also, if you wish, you can switch to phone audio or go to the audio settings. If we click on the audio settings, we will have lots of options that we can adjust. For normal user, these options will not be used much. If you have some problems with sound, you can try to click on the advanced button. Here, you will be able to process your audio quality. You can test this to see what version is best for you. Now let's go to the video. Here, you also can enable or disable the video with a single click. If you click also on the arrow, you will see also some interesting options. You will have the possibility to choose the webcam to use. This is useful if you have an incorporated webcam and also a better webcam. Also, on this menu, we have video settings. If the video is okay for you, I do not think you need to change any settings here. Lots of settings. You can test it one by one. Now, one of the most used features of Zoom is the virtual background for the camera. You find this option also on the video menu. Click on Virtual Background. Here, select what virtual background you wish to use. The background from you will disappear and be replaced with this image. Please note this is not perfect, but most cases does the trick. Now let's continue with the next option, Invite. Here you can send an invite to a contact, an email, or just simply copy the invitation URL. You find here the password also for your meeting. Let's invite using Gmail. Now the person is invited to my meeting. Another option from the meeting is to manage participants. Here, you can mute all, unmute all, and see the list of participants. Also, you can remove people who are in the meeting if you want by clicking their username and click Remove option. Because you are the host, you will see also a More button. Click it. option Mute Participants on Entry will make so people who enter into the meeting to be muted. Allow participants to unmute themselves is a very good option to use. If you wish only you to talk, you can disable this option and the person will not be able to say anything. Only the host will allow the person who can talk. Allow participants to rename themselves is pretty explanatory. This option will make a notification sound when somebody enters or exits the meeting. Lock meeting will make so that other people cannot join the meeting after this is activated. Another important feature is the share screen feature. You can share your full screen, an application window that is open, like mine is Chrome, or you can share a whiteboard. I will talk more in a dedicated video about all of these options. Please check the description of the video for this. Let's just test whiteboard. Nice. Also, the arrow near the share screen has some interesting features. You can allow one person to share the screen at a time or multiple persons. That's a very good option also. The chat option will give you access to send private messages. Let's send a message to everyone. Because you are the host, you can tap also on the three dots from the bottom and adjust the privacy for the chat. You can allow person to talk with you, with everyone, or with no one. The next button is called Record. This will record the meeting. This is very useful because you can send the meeting record to somebody who was not available. Also, you can pause the record or just stop it if you want. And the last option is reaction. This is a very nice feature and will allow the host to see your reactions. So, Zoom has great features and options. I hope you like this short presentation and please be sure to check our playlist for Zoom tutorials. And the last, let's see how to create a schedule meeting on Windows. To schedule a meeting, just tap the schedule button. Here, you can give a name for your meeting. Now, select a date. You can also select a start time for the meeting and a duration. You can make so this meeting to be recurring, depending on your needs. On Meeting ID, you can set up it to generate it automatically or just use your personal ID. If you generate automatically, then you need to give this ID to the person who you wish to invite and only him can know this, as this is random. If you select your personal ID, if somebody has it, can try to crash your meeting. Also, you can set up a password if you wish here. You can disable also the password for the meeting if you want. After that, you can set up that the video for the host to be on and also the video for the participants. You can set up how will the audio be used, only by telephone, computer audio or both. You can add the meeting on your calendar to be reminded. After you have set up all of these options, you can look also on advanced options. Let's take a look. If you enable the waiting room, when a person enters the meeting, it will get first time in a waiting room. The host must allow the person to join the meeting. If you enable the option Enable Join before the host, then participants can enter into the meeting before the host and can talk. Mute participants on entry is very useful if you wish so that people do not bother the meeting when they enter. You have also the option to automatically record the meeting on your local computer. Let's click now Schedule. Because I selected Google Calendar, I have to log in with Google to add a reminder on the calendar. So, select here your account that you use or simply log in into your Google account. Here, tap Allow. After this, you will be able to add a calendar event. After you have changed what info you wish, click on Save. Now, close the browser. Let's go back to the Zoom software. When you wish to start the meeting, from the top, just select Meetings. On this list, select the new meeting you created. Now click Start to open the new meeting. You have now started your scheduled meeting. All of these options from this window I already explained in a previous video about creating a new meeting. Just check the description to get all of this info. Now you have created and started a new scheduled meeting. If this was useful, please like, share and subscribe. Also, if you have any questions, please ask them on the comments area below.